New Zealand story. The Rainyang comes from Invercargill, the southernmost city in New Zealand. Her ancestors immigrated from Scotland and named all the streets in the town after Scottish rivers, which is why Lorraine is adept at both Scottish country dancing and performing the haka. Lorraine was born on 9th of December 1946, whilst Ronnie, Lorraine's dad, was away in the war in Europe. His wife Mamie had an affair with his brother. He returned to find Mamie pregnant, and Lorraine became their sweetest gift. Lorraine did not know this truth until age 32, when we were about to leave New Zealand for Europe. We met at Kaiteriteri Beach at the top of the South Island of New Zealand when we were both 23 years old and taking a break, doing healthy outdoors seasonal work in the sunshine. Lorraine worked on a farm picking apples while I was picking tobacco. Lorraine was a knockout, being stunningly sexy, yet with a girl next door demeanour who, would you believe, eats kiwi fruit whole, including the furry skin. After the season finished, we wrote and couldn't wait to get together. Lorraine joined me in Timaru, where she worked as a seamstress in a factory alongside 80 women knitting wool garments. Lorraine was promoted to work with the designers due to her flair with patterns. If I walked Lorraine to work, I wasn't allowed to kiss her at the factory gates, or else she would be ribbed all day. We lived in a valley in a shepherd's cottage set in an apricot orchard on a farm. Lorraine's cats chased the farmer's quad bike loaded with his dogs. The cats wanted to be sheepdogs too. Life was idyllic, with a huge circle of friends from music, work and sport. Lorraine's cousins, Shona, Debbie and Gary, visited us there. Christmas we spent with Lorraine's parents in Invercargill, where we had delicacies like whitebait caught by her father and mutton birds from Lorraine's Maori uncle, who was permitted to catch them on Stewart Island, just south of Invercargill. Which is why Lorraine maintains New Zealand is made up of three islands, not two. Lorraine's sporting prowess was golf. Her first golf lesson went so well, she jumped with joy, and we both played for many years. For the 1974 Commonwealth Games in Christchurch, we visited every day and watched as John Walker and Philbert Bayi from Tanzania both broke the 1500 metres world record. On leaving New Zealand, we were amazingly upgraded to seats A1 and A2 in the first class cabin, where the owners of Delta Airlines invited us to join them for dinner in their restaurant as we flew to London. Lorraine, the smile that lights your face, my love, the curl in your hair, the way you hold my hand to show how much you care, the glow of health that radiates from your unwrinkled brow, the movement of your earrings, those pouting lips that wow me to a standstill each time they brush my chest, the butterflies that linger in my belly cease to rest. When your big, cool eyes devour me in their forward, frank embrace, I'm struck by perfect beauty, posture, shape and grace of your body and your bearing to your finely sculptured neck, which attracts 1,000 kisses, nibbles, bites and pecks all over, past your shoulders, around your throat as well. I've planted oh so many, but there's many more to dwell there. For I'm overcome by feelings from the laughter in your eyes, as we share each twinkling moment with a look, a wink, a sigh. While the shortness of your person is a turn on just for me, as you stretch right up on tiptoe without unbended knee, to whisper or to welcome, whenever we are near, falls the fragrance of your perfume to linger in the air. Which reminds me of the female in you, sensual, pressing, dear, full of feeling, passion, urgency, topped off by burning lust. Lorraine, I love you, sweetheart, and there's much more, not this, just. UK and Europe story. Arriving in the UK in 1978, we bought a car and caravan to tour Europe for 6 months. The next holiday, we drove to Saint-Tropez in our E-Type Jaguar, where our car was known as La Belle Voiture. In Saint-Tropez, we bought a special dress that we really couldn't afford at the time. It became Lorraine's Saint-Tropez dress. This started a trend where we bought one special dress at every exotic place we holidayed and called the dress by the name of the city. One holiday on the Greek island of Spetsi we remember well. A photo of Lorraine on our terrace I commissioned into an oil painting that hangs over our mantelpiece today. After 2 years, the UK wanted to deport Lorraine, even though we were both in full-time work, owned an apartment, had a joint bank account, and had lived together for 10 years. To stay, we visited the registry office to get married. In November 1982, we started our business together, producing a document binding machine called Paper Welder. Shona, our New Zealand cousin, lived with us for 2 years, working as a mainstay in the company. Andrew and Rose's sons, Graham and Angus, stayed with us, working long hours in the business. That same year, Lorraine got the first of her 3 dogs that we had over the next 30 years, finishing with Honey, who never left her side. Lorraine took each of her dogs to work, first by bus and train. When Lorraine was thrilled to pass her driving test, her dogs were chauffeured everywhere. In 4 years of business, sales grew rapidly through exports, and in 1986, after the BBC had visited our premises for filming and interviews, they invited us to a posh lunch where Prince Charles presented us with the BBC Radio 4 Small Business Enterprise Award. By the mid-90s, trading as Folders Galore, we had 50 employees. Lorraine, with her dog beside her, loved working on her computer to find every last penny of a project to invoice. We holidayed a lot, mostly in Puerto Banús and Ibiza. We visited Paris each year, where we stayed in a hotel with its own jazz club, with a style of music we loved to dance to. Tenerife, in the Canary Islands, became our second home, where we wintered for 6 months at a time. Whilst there in 2015, we bought rings with sapphire stones, representing our 45 years together. We saw many London shows. Perhaps the top one was at the Royal Opera House, where we had dinner in their posh restaurant and watched the ballet Spartacus. The Adagio from Spartacus became our favourite orchestral piece of music. Lorraine had both hips replaced by 2011. Since 2012, Lorraine was diagnosed with Alzheimer's. As there is no cure, we decided to lead our life as normal. Throughout her years of Alzheimer's, Lorraine has not been on any medication. In 2015, I took Lorraine back to Kaitaitiri Beach in New Zealand, where we first met, hoping the sight would jog her mind out of her predicament, all to no avail. In December 2017, we visited New Zealand again to see her friends and relatives for the last time. Thank goodness that we had a full dose of life before Alzheimer's closed the memories. Amigos para siempre, or friends forever. Alzheimer's has you in her grip, yet I know you feel no pain. You take it in your stride, sweetheart, my lovely Lorraine. Your big smile tugs my heartstrings, you jig to tunes so well. You cannot read, write, walk, nor talk, but I love to hear you yell. You exude enduring happiness, but can't remember day to day. Let's live our lives as normal, in our own embracing way. The whole world smiles with you when they meet and have their say. Friends want to follow your story, becoming amigos para siempre.
There's a light, a certain kind of light that never shone on me. I want my life to be live with you, live with you. There's a way, everybody say, do each and every little thing. But what does it bring if I ain't got you? If I ain't got you, baby, you don't know what it's like. Baby, you don't know what it's like to love somebody. Love somebody the way I love you. In my brain, I see your face again. I know my frame of mind. You ain't gotta be so blind. So very blind. I'm a man. Can't you see I am? I live and I breathe for you. But what good does it do if I ain't got you? If I ain't got you.
You don't know, baby. You don't know.
it's like. Sing it up. Tell me
you don't know what it's like.
Hey, keep it going now. Sing it to me. Tell me now.
You don't know what it's like.
Oh, it sounds so good.
You don't know what it's like.
Love somebody to love somebody the way I love you.
The rain, this cannot be. Wildlife in our garden stops foraging around. They know there's something up. They sense it so profound. Pigeons on a bough shift from leg to leg, staring into distance whence their corn was fed. Will the lady of the house visit us once more? There's an overbearing silence from her home, that's for sure. The brazen fox is preening, the naughty squirrel bounds, the watchful red robin his tiny chest expands. Swallows loop the loop, hearing blackbird's strident song, parading in the centre, Lord Magpie stomps along. The flock of flying parakeets squawk as they descend on their overlooking tree. Is the rain now on the mend? Wildlife strains to listen, steps closer, scared to see. Their supportive cry arises, the rain, this cannot be.
Thank you. If she asks if you're all